The other day, my man hit me with, he was just like, oh, babe, do you want to climb a mountain? I said, emotionally? Because as a black woman, I do that every day. I cannot stand certain motherfuckers that do crazy things. I cannot stand an adult in their 40s, 50s, whatever, that leave their home with a pillow from their bedroom and take that shit to the airport. And sleep on the plane. What is wrong with you, you weak, weak bitch? Unfollow me. Delete. We're done. What, you're 45 years old and you need your blanket? I can't. I cannot.
Elon Musk be going to space by himself. What the fuck is that white man doing in space alone? That's not suspicious to anybody but me. If this motherfucker goes to space without the government, without NASA, which I didn't even know you could fucking do. As far as I knew, they were the space niggas. They run space. You want to fuck with space, you got to fuck with them. This motherfucker built a spaceship like it's a go-kart, goes on Tuesdays. Bitch, space day is Saturday! Everybody know that! You can't leave midweek to go to goddamn space. It's an event. It happens Saturday, the TV's on. This nigga be going Wednesday night. What? From Sacramento at that. Bitch, space place is Cape Canaveral. That's where you go from. Ain't no entry point to Mars from fucking Sacramento. And when you go into space, you at least tell the people, it's a PSA. You get on the goddamn news, you say, hey people, I'm about to go fuck around in space. Don't be alarmed. This nigga just went. We thought it was aliens. Is it aliens? No, it's just Elon doing donuts in the sky. What the fuck is this? White man ambition is some shit. You wanna know what a racism is? That's where the fuck it is, white man. Cause I know y'all still confused. Look at him. What are you talking about? Fucking confused. Cause they don't get, cause everyone learns the history. So you're like, well, no one's getting hung and we ain't beating nobody. And I work next to a black guy and he has a car, so equality. Just lay the fuck down. Rest easy. Everything's fair. Fucking nut job. Everything's not fair. Cause while you're sleeping, you're dreaming about buying Mars, nigga. I've never thought I could do no shit like that a day in my life. I thought about having all the money. And you know what I thought? I was like, if I get all the money, I'm gonna buy them gold ceilings, Master P had in cribs. That's what the fuck I'ma do when I get all the goddamn money. Space by my goddamn self, bitch, never. Even if I thought about going to space, I'd call NASA first. Yo, NASA, this Sam, can I go? You know what it is, Tuesday. Space day is Saturday.
Let me tell you something. I'm loving my life right now. I love it. You know, I'm always having fun. I've always been a fun person. But you know what I noticed lately who haven't been having fun? The fucking 20-year-olds. Yeah, 20-year-olds, y'all suck. Y'all are the worst 20-year-olds. In the history of our 20-year-olds, ever. Let me tell y'all something. Look, the nation depends on 20-year-olds. Like, if we're going through some bad stuff, which we always do, the nation always go through some bad stuff, if we can still look at the 20-year-olds and 20-year-olds is just like, then we like, oh, okay, we all right. But you look at the 20-year-olds now, and the 20-year-olds now be like, ah! I am so offended. You be like, what are you offended about? You literally only been through high school. What's wrong, boo? You didn't catch Pikachu? Did Pikachu get away from you? You better enjoy your damn 20s. Y'all out here marching. That's hilarious. Ain't nobody listening to a 20-year-old. I never marched in my 20s. The only marching I did in my 20s was to the liquor store. Yeah.
Bacardi. Tequila. Do you think I knew who the president was in my fucking 20s? Hell no! Every 20-year-old's night should end with glitter and cocaine.
The robots are coming. They're advanced. They look just like women. They don't gain weight because they don't eat bagels and shit. They're supposedly perfect, which is fine. Let them come. But my problem with them is every time there's some kind of sex advancement for men, there's always this tone of like, women better watch out. Y'all better get y'all shit together. You gonna get replaced. Men ain't gonna need you no more. And I'm like, when? Like, hurry up. Like, go. Go fuck the robots. Like, leave us alone. When is gonna happen? Stop threatening me with a good time. Go away. Like, what the fuck are you talking about? Go fuck your robot. Like, men are so weird. Men are so weird. I have a dildo, but I'll put a fucking face on it. Like, what's wrong with you?
Whenever I see a white man thriving, I'm always suspect, you know? I see him, I'm like, what are you planning? One time I was walking, and there was this young, fit white guy, and he was jogging, and he was waiting at the light for the light to change. So he's, you know, jogging, honey, gotta keep that heart rate up. He's not wearing a shirt. I was like, quit bragging. And he had his earbuds in, and he just is chuckling to himself. And I just had this vision of just grabbing those AirPods out of his ears, being like, what the hell are you laughing at? Why? Was I so rude? I didn't do it, but I wanted to. I realized why, though. You know why, honey? You know why? The reason why I don't trust that white boy, Joy, it's because it's been happening. It's been happening for years. And I've had this suspect. It's not for the reasons you think, okay? I don't trust white men because most white men were once white boys, all right? And as a child of the 80s and 90s, every movie and TV show I watched was about a little white boy getting into trouble and having bad energy, okay? These little white boys love making friends with an extraterrestrial, okay? They will go ahead and find a gremlin, okay? Little white, they having close encounters of the third kind. What are the other two? What are the other two encounters? We don't know! Little white boys, I'll tell you right now, little white boys love opening a portal to another dimension. Honey, these bitches will open up a portal and leave you to pick up the pieces. That's a fact. Have you ever seen the movie The Gate? This is from 1989, very formative for me. And it's literally about two little white boys home alone for a holiday weekend, and they open up a pathway to hell. Why couldn't they just order a pizza like everybody else? I don't trust it. It's to the point where nothing scares me more. No image shakes me to my core like seeing one or more white boys riding bicycles. I see a bitch on a bike, I'm going in the opposite direction. I'm in faith, because it means there's a poltergeist afoot. And I do not want to be caught in those crosshairs. I'm going to sit here right now. I'm trying to live.
The other day, my man hit me with, he's just like, oh, babe, do you want to climb a mountain? I said, emotionally? Because as a black woman, I do that every day. Yes, sis. Yes, white girl. Tell your aunties how to vote. Tell your aunties how to vote. You know, you do have to do what your partner likes to do. And when you're like different nationalities and different countries, it's just hard sometimes. Like, I'm with a white boy, yes. So I understand I'm have to do some white boy shit. But European white boy is next level white boy shit. Real talk. Like, the other day, we were home, I was working. He's like, babe, come meet me outside. I said, let me put my shoes on. Hold up. He's like, you don't need your shoes? I said, yes, I do. And you do too. I go meet him outside. He's like, put your phone away. I said, let me drop this pen first. I don't know what activity this is. This is new. He's like, give me your hands. I was like, ah!
Is this a rose ceremony? This ain't cute.
And he goes, let's look at the sun. And let's try to guess what time it is. I said, motherfucker, I got a job. I'm trying to get that ass wiping money. Go fly your kite somewhere else. To be that bored and confident. I don't get it.
Are there black people here? Ooh, yes! I got one right in the front! Yes, Rosa sat for us all! And it's not just buses. Can I... Can I ask you a question? Okay, so at the height of the Black Lives Matter protests last summer, I don't know about you, but every single white person I blinked at, waved at, smiled at, kicked a leg up at, texted me. I heard a lot of white laughter. They were like, yes, I texted. But did they text you? Yeah, did the text message say, if there's anything I can do, let me know? Yes, what the fuck, white people? I'm your only black friend? Keep that shit locked in your heart. Also, I don't need anything. I'm alive. But I do gotta say, I was deeply, truly offended that the only white people who didn't text me were all the white dudes I ever fucked. I was like, excuse me! Do black lives only matter when you're inside of one?
Hit the shit!
They're just disrespectful. Kids are disrespectful. Women, we don't have to have them, you know, ladies. We don't have to have kids. Like, they're just, why? They're not worth it a lot of the time. They ain't got no banter. Kids ain't got no banter. They don't say anything exciting. I drew a giraffe. Fuck off. Do you know what I mean? Give a fuck about your giraffe. They're really overrated. Who's got kids here? Make some noise if you've got kids. Okay, the ladies. I like that the men did not make noise. Men, you don't have kids. You get kids, okay? Kids are like pets to you. Actually, they're dogs. A bitch had to give birth to them so you can play with them and pretend they're yours, okay? That's the reality. Now, kids are shit, and you'll relate to this, baby girl, because I think babies are disrespectful to women. They are. Babies are disrespectful to women. I tell you what, as a woman, you catch a sudden case of dick, it results in a pregnancy, 9 months. 9 months. People go to go, 9 months. No, 9 months. 9 long months. Making a human in your gut. Making eyes, ears, and elbows in your gut. Making a human in your gut. Can't even drink to get yourself through it. Making eyes, ears, and elbows in your gut for 9 months. Fully formed. A fully formed human. Not like in IKEA. Fully formed human in your fucking gut for 9 months. 9 months. Can't drink. Making a human. 9 months. 9 months. 9 long months. Making a human in your gut. Then you gotta push that fucker out. You gotta push it out. It might take 2 days. It might take 2 fucking days. It will rip your vagina. Rip it out. Ruin it. Ruin it. Ruin it. 9 months. Ruin. 9 months. Ruin. You push that shit out and there's blood. 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 Blood everywhere. Blood on the face. Blood. Blood. You pick up the bloody baby. You pick up the bloody baby. And you cut the cord. You cut your jeune. You cut it. You hold the baby. You look at it and it has the audacity to look exactly like the father. Are you fucking kidding me? If that was me, I'd leave out the hospital. Like, I don't know who that is.
A lot of new adventures and stuff. I'm in a divorce, we're in a new relationship. That feels great. Got a new girl. Had to go buy a new dick. That's the lesbian unspoken rule. New bitch, new dick. You gotta do it. Can't come into new relationships with old dicks. You can't do it. I was telling my homie, I was like, yeah, man, I got a new girl. I got to go buy a new dick. He started, like, ragging on me. He was like, that's stupid. I don't have to bring a new dick in that relationship. I bring the same dick. I was like, yeah, because you can't. You dummy. Do you not know women? If she knew you could get a new dick, you'd have to. You not understand how they work, stupid?